When I was 5, I always wanted to be a chemical engineer. My father was a great chemical engineer. He lived his profession day and night, and so I saw what engineers do and how they do it, and I loved it. And I guess it rubbed off because my older son is also a chemical engineer. I didn't think of becoming a food engineer at all. It came about strictly by luck. I graduated doing a PhD here in chemical engineering, U of T. My major was catalysis, which is more or less focused towards the petrochemical industry. When I graduated, I was hired into the brand new office of Cambrian Engineering, which was Saskatoon-based. And all of a sudden, we had to look after an edible oil refinery in Nipawin, Saskatchewan. And so I had to quickly become an expert in edible oils. Food industry is the largest industry in the world, both in terms of the number of people employed and the number of dollars spent. Large-scale processing of food really is based on chemical engineering. All the unit operations, heat transfer, mass transfer, it's essentially cooking. They all work on the same basis as petrochemical processes, except you do it with a different temperature, different pressure, and of course you look out for microbial contamination, which is of course food safety is the critical thing in food. Much more so than any other aspect of it.
Professor Diosady has always been very honest and willing to make everything work for his students. And he still has a fantastic reputation with all of his graduate students.
I teach reasonably well in small groups, and I certainly have been pretty successful with the graduate students. I'm very proud of the fact that 15, I think maybe by next week will be 16 of my students are professors across North America. I have one of my students is the president of a university. One of them is a dean. One of them is chair in Africa.
I don't know how many professors can say the work that they do impacts millions. He really does bring hope, or sometimes in many places where there's none.
I had a postdoctoral fellow and said, well, you know somebody from a chemical engineer from India who's this idea of putting iron on salt and would like to do a couple experiments. Would we work with him? And this was Venkatesh Munnar. The first large-scale testing of our double fortified salt was in India in 2008, roughly. Did a small pilot test by Indian standards. 3.5 million children were fed school lunches prepared by our double fortified salt. It boggles the mind. You couldn't find 3.5 million people for a full program, never mind for a pilot program here. And at the end of 8 months, the number of anemic children decreased by 34%.
The work itself is extremely impactful on people's lives. The double fortified salt is being rolled out in implementation programs across India. It's going to improve the health and save the lives of millions and millions of people in India. I think very few academics can say that they have that kind of impact. He inspires his students, undergraduates and graduate students, to do similar kinds of work. And I would also say that he has been the inspiration for the formation of our Center for Global Engineering.
I remember very specifically a map that he had of the world in his office. And he truly prided himself of bringing in international students from all over the world.
In our own microcosm in chemical engineering, and in my group in particular, I get exposed to people from all the different continents and different philosophies and different interests. And so we get to see and understand a little bit better how the rest of the world works. And we also get to have a better feeling of the size of problems and the opportunities there are for engineering.